Aussie performance artist Sarah McCreanor, better known as Smac or Hydraulic Press Girl, has made her gallery debut. She's made a name for herself by getting squished or turning herself into an emoji. And with more than 2 million TikTok followers, she's taken social media by storm. Her weird and wonderful work, though, is now on display at the NGV, if you don't mind, in Melbourne.
Wow. We are going to get the lowdown from the internet's biggest crush, Sarah. Welcome. Now, firstly, quick question. Why? Why do I do this? Oh, man, I ask myself that all the time. I mean, it's just, it's really fun, to be honest, and why not?
Why do you think these videos are so addictive? I can't stop watching them.
You know what? I think there's so many different layers that it's like every time you watch it, you might see something new. And I guess there's a bit of strategy having things side by side. You have to watch it at least twice. But it's like oddly satisfying and confusing but amusing, maybe.
Yeah, it is all those things. What's been your favourite thing to crush?
Oh, I mean, I think the Ferrero Rocher, because I still ate it afterwards. And that's been a crowd favourite, yeah.
So. Where did you first come up with this?
If you kind of look at my whole portfolio of content, it wasn't really out of the norm for me to do something like this. I tend to mimic things, just it's a good challenge, and it's kind of fun to do something that wouldn't really be danceable. So once I stumbled upon the original Hydraulic Press channel videos, I was like, cool, I'll just dance that. That looks like choreography to me. And it was just that simple.
So has it changed the way you look at the world, Sarah? Do you look at things now as things you can crush and things you might not crush?
Yes, definitely. But I've always looked at how I can perform the unperformable thing. So I think I didn't really change it with that. But yes, I definitely, when I'm out and about and I see something small enough to fit in the hydraulic press machine, I'm like, I have an outfit that will match that. Let's do it.
Because it's silly, but at the same time, it's great. It's like it's this high concept thing. And it's gone from like TikTok to triennial exhibition at the moment at the National Gallery of Victoria. Have you been in the gallery space and watched people watch your stuff?
Oh, I'm getting chills just thinking about it because I had never seen my work, first of all, in a fine art gallery. I never thought that would happen. The circumstances was amazing. And then I actually got to witness the general public seeing it, and they didn't know I was there. I'm just observing them and seeing people actually cackle in person for the first time, because usually my work is viewed privately on your phone, on your computer. So I've never seen anyone's reactions. I've only been able to judge by the numbers or the comments. But seeing it in person was absolutely incredible. And, yeah, it was super moving for me to, like, kind of re-experience that with everyone.
Well, you also physically recreate emojis. They're my favourite things to watch. What was your favourite one to do and what was the hardest one?
You know what? The hardest one was the love heart because I just couldn't figure it out if I wanted to do, like, some unusual on-the-ground yoga position, but I wanted it to be up high, so I ended up jumping and having to freeze-frame that. I think my favourite one, though, possibly some of the animals or, like, the disco man.
Yep. Yeah.
That's always fun. Probably, yeah.
Hey, Sarah, is there an emoji you could do for us now in the confines of your studio?
Oh, yeah. Is there anything?
Could I do the, you know, the black check mark?
Oh, yeah.
Oh! Yay! That was perfect.
I was cheating. I'm sitting on a chair. It was easy.
Hey, still involved a lot of core strength. Thank you so much, Sarah.
Thank you.